Hey guys, we took the heat shield out of the rear of my car because I'm having it all apart. We might as well take everything out and paint and try to prevent corrosion by painting everything, rust proofing. And I figure it'd be a great day to do a video on how to make these heat shields stop from rattling. Big disclaimer here, guys, you have to make sure the product that you're using is rated for what we're about to do. So I have a combination of Dynamat and Stinger Roadkill. This is just extra stuff I had in the shop. We're not gonna see any of this because I'm putting it on the other side. So I'm relying on the aluminum to help shield the heat, but I'm gonna put this on the back side to help us reduce any resonance. You see here, it doesn't have that tinny sound, like it's a piece of tin. It doesn't have that tinny sound anymore. But we're gonna add a strip here. This is the most important part as far as getting rid of that noise, because we're gonna create a bushing between the shield and the floorboard. Heat shields have one purpose and one purpose only. So what they're there to do is to protect crucial components or areas that are gonna be uncomfortable for the driver. So anywhere that builds up heat, there might be electrical components or your feet might be near it, they will install these guys. So it's typically thin aluminum. So they don't wanna add too much cost or weight to the vehicle, but it has this tendency to resonate. So there's a couple reasons why. One, it's just the way the material is, it just wants to resonate and then it creates noise. But also here where it mounts, so you have metal on metal, and if it gets loose, your car will hit certain harmonics, and depending on the RPM or speed that you're traveling, and then it makes this guy rattle against the floorboards, and then what do you guys do? You end up ripping out the whole thing. So I don't really recommend ripping out these. They are there for a reason, either for vehicle operation near wiring, or there for driver comfort. You know, your interior gets too hot afterwards, depending on where these guys are. So I'm going to show you guys an alternative to ripping out heat shields to get rid of the noise and actually help them operate better. Another reason your heat shield might be rattling is because the fasteners have gotten loose. So I just use some Threadlock glue on them and then tighten them down snug. Now keep in mind, whenever you use Threadlock, it acts like a lubricant. So if you're ever torquing things to spec, you might easily over torque because the tool can't sense it because it's acting like a lubricant. So just be mindful of that when using this stuff. I've now done this side. So you can see that's just one strip, and then I've made the holes here. That way when I reinstall, it's gonna be a lot easier. So we just have to repeat the process over here. Here's another little trick that I do with bracing. So this particular part just helps tie everything together to give the vehicle more rigidity. So I put a thin layer, I push through a screwdriver to get all my holes so I can mount it back up, but I only put it on the top side. And I only put in the areas where the mounting hardware meets up to the vehicle. So this is what actually touches the vehicle. So as it compresses, you can still torque it down to factory specifications so then you're not out of whack, but this will help act as a bushing to help reduce interior resonance. If you really wanted to come up with a little more stealth, if you don't use black stuff, you can just paint over it. But when you put it up, you're really not gonna see it at all. But if you wanna take it this extra step, you totally can. So what do you guys think? Would you do something like this? Like, I know a lot of people just rip off these heat shields. I'm not a big fan of it, but at the same time, I'm not a fan of heat shields the way they're installed either. I find that if you can make this work, if it's gonna operate properly in the temperature and the conditions, this is a much better way as far as being a hybrid between making it sound better and making it more effective all at the same time. If you like today's content, make sure to check out my channel and hit the subscribe button and make sure to hit that bell notification. What that does is it makes sure that you're always kept up to date with all the content that we're providing with you guys on YouTube. So the way that we have the channel set up is I have the uploads up top. That way at all times, you can always see, if you just hop by the channel, what our latest upload is. Plus with the bell notification, you're going to get some sort of message from YouTube itself.
We also have popular uploads, car videos, how-to videos, demonstration and informational videos, and a lot of cool other specific car videos like our builds playlist. I really like the builds playlist because it takes all the theories from our how-to section and it keeps applying it to different vehicles.